for your weekend. Be sure to stay with us for all the details.
Now on the morning Augustus served yet. Time for a check of our forecast with Jenna. Jenna, you said you have great news for us today.
That's right, Sean, and part of that is this sunrise this morning. It looks like a fireball in the sky. Earlier today, we had a lot of cloud cover, but now the sun is starting to peek through those clouds as we look at our SkyView Network cam at Augusta Marriott. Temperatures are in the upper 60s and low 70s, so just a little bit cooler than average. 69 in Augusta, Allendale, and Thompson, you're waking up at 70 degrees. 68 in Aiken, 72 in Swainsboro, Wrightsville at 71, and 68 in Crawfordville. So as I mentioned, a little bit cooler than the last 24 hours. We're seeing a 4-degree temperature drop in Augusta, 3-degree difference in Aiken. Winds are coming in from the northeast, a little bit breezy in some of our western counties, seeing 6 to 7 miles per hour. That onshore wind is bringing us a little bit of moisture today as this cold front continues to linger to ourselves. So the good news is that we are done with the rain and the storms. Those are no longer affecting any land, but we will still have just a little bit of moisture keeping some lingering clouds today. But yesterday we picked up a good amount of rainfall, especially to the east of the river. 0.43 inches in Aiken, 0.17 in Augusta. Definitely some brief heavy downpours, but none of that in the forecast today. It's going to be fantastic. 86 degrees by 5 p.m., so staying in those upper 80s today with partly cloudy skies. I'll have more details on your forecast this weekend and the week ahead coming up, but back to you, Sean.
Looks fantastic to me, Jenna. Thank you. A back-to-school drive is happening in Aiken today. It'll take place from 9 until 12 at the Clyburn Center for Primary Care that's over on Clyburn Place. 240 backpacks will be given out while supplies last. There will also be face paintings and haircuts. Kids must be present and of school age, and you're asked not to line up before 9 a.m. As far as that Miami vacation,
quick fire roasted tomato and olive oil. Bring it with Triscuit.
In the U.S. alone, there's a cyber attack every 39 seconds. Choosing complex passwords and changing them often will help to fend off would-be attacks.
Visit WJBF.com/cyber, sponsored by Premier Networks.
Welcome to Davis Appliance and Furniture. Welcome to Davis Appliance and Furniture, where you can find the best deals in town. We offer new and used appliances, and we service what we sell. We offer no credit needed financing and delivery options to meet your needs. For the top brands and lowest prices in town, visit us at Davis Appliance and Furniture.
Now, your most accurate forecast with WJBF Live Viper 6.
Good Saturday morning. In case you missed it earlier, here's another look at our SkyView Network cam over at Augusta Marriott. Beautiful sunrise this morning. The cloudy conditions are starting to part ways, leaving us with lovely sunshine to kick off the morning. Temperatures are in the upper 60s and low 70s, sitting at 69 now in Augusta. Dew point at 68, still a pretty muggy, typical summertime morning with visibility down to 7 miles. We are in those anywhere from 68 to, say, 72 degrees this morning, a little bit warmer in some of our western and southern counties. The cold front that brought us all the rain yesterday is now to the south of us, keeping all the showers and storms out to sea. Just some lingering clouds this morning that will continue throughout the afternoon, but definitely no rain in the forecast. Moving on to the tropics real quickly, we do have an area that we're watching just 10% chance of development over the next 48 hours and 5 days. This is along the coastline of Texas, so not a lot of opportunity for development here, but definitely some heavy rain headed towards the Texas coastline over the next couple of days. Moving back to our forecast here in town, 88 degrees today, 0% chance of rain for your entire weekend. 90 tomorrow, but a cooler start to the day with a low of 64. A great day for the pool. We'll have partly cloudy conditions, only heating up into those upper 80s, so you definitely won't get super hot if you're spending a lot of time outside. It'll also help that our dew points are lower over the next couple of days, anywhere from 62 to 65 degrees. So typically in the summertime, we're above 70, making it feel much more humid. So definitely a nice treat for the next couple of days. Our low temperature or high temperatures will go up to 92 degrees for the start of the work week, but then drop right back down into those upper 80s. So below average days to come as well. Our former forecast showing dry conditions throughout parts of the CSRA. So a little bit more rain is needed, but for today, 0%. So once again, definitely enjoy the nice conditions. I highly recommend some outdoor plans. Also, rain chances are going up over the next few days, 40% from Monday through Wednesday, then higher rain chances to end the week. So it won't be the ahead, so definitely enjoy this weekend with the nice conditions while they last. We'll have an onshore wind today, keeping a little bit of moisture around, so today will just be a little bit more muggy than tomorrow. Future cast showing a few spotty showers around 4 o'clock, but I definitely don't expect any heavy rain by any means, maybe just a brief shower. And then by tonight, clearing conditions. Sunday morning is going to be very sunny and overall a really nice day for Sunday. No rain in sight. But as we go into Monday and Tuesday, we will have an additional cold front approaching us, bringing us a better chance of some more scattered storms that will linger into the rest of the work week as well. And the Storm Prediction Center has issued a marginal risk of severe weather from Augusta and Aiken northward for Monday. So stay with us throughout the week for more details on that. Highs today will be in the upper 80s. Lows tonight going to be much cooler compared to average 64 in Augusta. Your 10-day forecast showing the partly cloudy conditions today, mostly sunny tomorrow, heating up to 90 degrees, 92 on Monday with rain chances increasing, but the majority of the week will just be in the upper 80s, Sean.
So, Jenna, a little muggy today, but no rain.
Yeah, that's right. And tomorrow, much lower humidity.
Sounds good to me. Thank you. So you can drink wine and your cage do it too. And what's trending and is next. Wine really tastes better when you're on vacation? Well, now you can get paid to find out. British winemaker Majestic is looking for a vintner. They'll fly you to the Iberian Peninsula for vacation so you can taste the wines of Spain and Portugal. Majestic will supply the wine at about $240 a day of spending money. Then you can take a case of wine back home to try, and then you can see if there's really a difference in how they taste in different places. No previous wine tasting experience is required, but a vinternship is only for UK residents only.
Vinternship, I like that, Sean. That's probably the coolest internship out there.
Absolutely.
Well, Louis Vuitton's latest accessory might go well with a fresh coat. The luxury fashion brand has unveiled a new paint can bag. It's styled like a real paint can and even features a polished chrome metal handle with a ring top that flips open. Louis Vuitton says the bag will come in 6 different colors, and no, it's not cheap. In fact, you could probably paint your whole house for the price of one. It's $2,850.
My goodness. Would you get one of these, Jenna?
I would not. I would never buy a Louis Vuitton bag in general, I'm sure. I'm too cheap for that, Sean.
I don't need one anyway, but yeah. And I could do a lot of stuff with $2,850.
That's right.
So check this one out. Behold the barbecue Reese's peanut butter cup sandwich, and it's now for meals, definitely not recommended by your doctor. The Kansas City Royals unveiled a new snack and a half being sold at games. The barbecue Reese's sandwich is pulled pork with sweet baby Ray sauce, plus it's stuffed with Reese's pieces inside and bacon, and it's only $11. They had me with everything else, Jenna, and then when it got to the Reese's peanut butter cups,
I know, and when I was looking at it just now, I thought for sure that had to be pulled pork in there. Mm-hmm. So at first I thought maybe it was just Reese's on there, which would be even weirder. I'm glad there's at least something normal on it.
Yeah, so take the Reese's out and I'll eat it.
Yeah, eat those for dessert.
Yes, well, coming up on Good Morning Augusta, the FBI agents raided former President Trump's Florida home in search of sealed official documents.
Good Sunday morning. This may be the nicest day we've had all summer with mostly sunny skies, much lower humidity, and below average temperatures. All the details on your forecast coming right up.
Now on Good Morning Augusta, Aiken County students headed back to school Monday. The changes being made. Plus nationwide, school districts scrambled to find ways to get kids back to campus amid a shortage of bus drivers. What's behind the problem? And later, seniors could see a major boost in their Social Security checks starting next year. We'll have details as your number one source for local weekend morning news starts right now. Health experts also say college-age students returning to dorm life are also at risk for the same common illnesses in addition to mono and sexually transmitted diseases. Time for a check of our forecast with Jenna. Hey, Jenna. Good morning.
Good morning, Sean. It's a lovely start to this Sunday morning. We're seeing a lovely sunrise on our Jiffy Loop, or just our Skyview Network cam over at Augusta Marriott. If you're stepping stepping outside the door this morning, you may notice temperatures are definitely cooler than normal. Check these out. 63 in Augusta, only at 61 now in Barnwell. Thompson, you're waking up at 64. Aiken at 62. Wrightsville in those upper 60s, 65 in Washington. So 6 degrees difference in Augusta and Aiken compared to 24 hours ago. All of us at least a little bit cooler than we were yesterday morning, with dew points also in those low 60s, and that will stay this way throughout the day, making it feel much less humid and also with a lot of sunshine. Satellite and radar not showing any clouds at this time, and as we zoom out to the Tuesday view, just some very spotty showers out to sea, nothing impacting land at this time, and that'll stay the way throughout the day, including your morning. Things will be really nice. I definitely recommend a amount of time outside today if you have the time for it. It's going to be beautiful. Mostly sunny, 75 by 10 a.m. up into those 80s later on this morning. Overall, a really nice weekend. Then as we go into Monday, we will be tracking some storms headed our way, but temperatures will remain below average throughout the week to come. More details on your forecast coming up, but back to you, Sean.
All right, Jenna, thank you. We're all short on time, but if you need to prepare a quick, easy meal for your family, Sarah Crawford with E-Meals is joining us to show us how. Hey, Sarah. We'll be right back. ABC. And welcome back. School is starting back, and parents may be looking for ways to prepare meals for their children. And joining me today to share some tips is Sarah Crawford. Sarah, thank you so much for joining us today.
Yes, hello, and welcome to one of our E-Meal Chef Kitchens. I'm so excited to show you some super easy meals that are going to be great for your back-to-school season.
And I'm excited, too, because I'm already hungry, Sarah. So what do you have for us?
Yes, so this is our cheesy meatloaf dinner. It is all created on this one sheet pan. You throw everything on the sheet pan, throw it in the oven. It's so easy. It has green beans, some potatoes, and then this amazing cheesy meatloaf. It's literally meatloaf with cheese stacked in the middle. So your kids are going to freak out over this. And it just has this amazing brown sugar glaze that is so delicious. And it takes all of about 30 minutes cooking. Everything is done so easy. Don't even have to think about it. And it's a great recipe.
Ah, sounds good to me. So give us the recipe. Go ahead, put the stuff together.
Yes. Yes, so this next recipe is our sheet pan sticky chicken dinner. So it's got a lot of Asian flavors, and it's so easy. I'm going to show you how to do it. You just take your garlic. I like to use 4 cloves of garlic. You can use as little or as much as you want, honestly. A little bit of brown sugar, because we all know that's where that glaze is going to come from, that sticky factor when we talk about sticky chicken. It's so, so delicious. A little bit of soy sauce. Again, we love all of those nice Asian flavors. And then the sesame oil that adds so much flavor. If you don't love sesame oil, feel free to use a different kind. You can use olive oil, all kinds of great oils out there that you can use instead. And then you're just going to stir all of that together. And then if you like spice, which I do, your kids might not like spice, but if you do, add a teensy bit of sriracha, and you can just splash a little bit in there. Use as much or as little as you like. That's what's so great is this recipe is totally customizable. You can use a little bit more or a little bit less of anything you want. I like to use chicken tenderloins. You can find chicken tenders, all kinds of things. Or if you can't find those, just take some boneless, skinless chicken breast, slice it down the middle, and make little chicken tenderloins out of it. And you're going to add that straight to the bowl. Again, this recipe is wonderful because you just add everything straight to the bowl, including your frozen vegetables. You can use fresh vegetables if you want to, but it's easy just to grab that Asian medley package from the freezer section, and you're just going to add it to the bowl, stir it all together, and all you're going to do next is grab a sheet pan, throw this all on the sheet pan, bake it at 425 for about 20 minutes, and you'll have dinner in a pinch, like so fast, so easy, and it's going to be great for the back-to-school season.
And that's pretty easy peasy. So, Sarah, what if we have kids who are picky eaters? Because there are some people like that. I'm one of those folks. Can you make any modifications to the recipes to appease those picky eaters?
Yes, absolutely. You can use any vegetable you want. You don't have to use the typical Asian medley. If you have a child that loves this specific vegetable or is more, you know, willing to eat this kind of vegetable, definitely throw that in there. But the great thing is that this is coated in a nice little... The sticky part of it, the fact that it has that brown sugar, the soy sauce, it makes the vegetables taste so much better, especially because you're roasting them bringing out the flavor. So I feel like your kids will be a little bit more willing to try this instead of just the raw vegetable. And again, it's so easy, but you're still getting all of those amazing nutrients from the vegetables for your kiddos.
Hey, Sarah, thank you so much for joining us today. I appreciate it. I think I'm going to go to that website and give you one of those recipes.
Yes, thank you for having me, and happy cooking.
Thank you. And we'll be right back.
Now, your most accurate forecast with WJBF Live Viper 6.
If you've been tired of the heat and humidity this summer, definitely take a step outside this morning and enjoy this cooler air we're experiencing, along with a lovely sunrise. We're seeing that on our Skyview Network cam at Augusta Marriott. Lovely sunny skies for this Sunday. And check out this temperature, only 63 degrees in Augusta. That's around 10 degrees below our normal temperature for this time of the year. Dew point in the low 60s as well. A nice, cooler, and less humid day in store for us, with all of us in those low to mid 60s today. No one at that 70 degree mark. As we look across the southeast, though, we are still seeing those upper 70s over in Texas, New Orleans in the mid 70s, 81 down in Tampa. But for us along the northeast and the Carolinas, or the southeast, that is 65 in Wilmington, 64 in Raleigh, 65 in Charlotte, but Augusta is the coolest spot on the map right now. Satellite radar just showing clear skies this morning. A few fair weather clouds in store for us today, but definitely no rain in sight. The cold front that passed on Friday is well out of our area now. We are still keeping an eye on the southern Texas coastline, 20% chance of development here. Really not a lot of room to grow, though, with this storm. Just a little bit of an opportunity for development as it heads inland into the Corpus Christi area. This is already bringing some showers and storms along the coastline. But other than that, nothing close to home when it comes to the tropics that we are watching at this time. Today will be great for the pool. Only 84 degrees by noon, but then getting a little bit hotter by 3 p.m. into that 90 degree mark. Dew points will stay in the low 60s today, right in between comfy and muggy, but I'd say definitely comfortable for the summertime. That's about the lowest dew point we will ever see in the month of August. Then as we go into the work week, though, those dew points will climb as we have more moisture in the air. The good thing is that temperatures will stay below average, though, making it feel much more tolerable throughout the week. We'll be seeing a lot of upper 80s. The highest temperature this week will be on Monday at 92. Lows will also be well below average in those upper 60s. Even on the days where we have some rain and clouds, we will still be on the cooler side with those lows. We are still seeing the spotty dry conditions in parts of the CSRA, so we could use a little bit more rainfall for this month, but for today, 0% chance. That will be changing, though, as we go into the work week. 40% chance of storms tomorrow. Tuesday will be our driest day, and we will definitely be finishing out the week with some pretty high rain chances, along with a lot of cloud cover in store. Another cold front is approaching tomorrow, but in the meantime, just those fair weather clouds passing today. A lot of sunshine, no rain in store until Monday afternoon, 4 o'clock. We'll start to see that line of storms move in as that cold front pushes in. Some heavy rain, gusty winds, hail also possible within this line, and that'll move out of here by around 7 with some additional heavy showers by 11 o'clock into, say, 2 o'clock Tuesday morning. The Storm Prediction Center has gone ahead and issued a marginal risk of severe weather from our northern counties down to the Waynesboro area, Barnwell also included within that risk. So keep an eye on that for tomorrow, and be sure to join Ryan Gold tonight, John Lynn tomorrow morning with updates on that. Mostly sunny today, though, definitely the nicest day out of the week, so go outside and enjoy it, because as we go into next week, rain chances are going up, but fortunately those temperatures will still be comfortable in the upper 80s.
So Jenna, folks can go out to the Greenway, enjoy the trail and the wildlife out there today.
Yes, definitely so much to do today. Go to the lake, maybe the pool, enjoy the sunshine.
Sounds good, Jenna, thank you. Well, check this out. President Biden spotted for the first time in public since he arrived in the Lowcountry on Wednesday. He was seen leaving Holy Spirit Catholic Church on John's Island with his son, Hunter Biden, after attending afternoon mass. The president is vacationing on Kiowa Island with his family, where he's expected to be for the next few days. And coming up, a new streaming service from a very different platform. This was trending, and it's next.
I'm Jenny Montgomery. Join me next time for a look at the arts. Les Reagan will be here from the Augusta Broadway Singers and Kevin Grogan from the Morris Museum talking about the Southern Soul and Song Series. See you Tuesday at 12:30 for Jenny.
And welcome back. Are you ready for another streaming service? The New York Times says Walmart is considering offering streaming content to its Walmart Plus subscribers. The company has reportedly held discussions with Paramount, Disney, and Comcast about what kind of content Walmart Plus could offer. We don't know if it will go anywhere, but Walmart has talked about offering video content and a streaming service like this in the past, but nothing came of it.
You know, I'm not ready for another streaming service. I think there's plenty of them so far.
Absolutely. You know, back in the day it was just Netflix, but now it's so many more. So yeah, I think
yeah,
I'm with you, Jenna.
I pretty much just stick with Netflix, and I'm happy with that. But in other news, a man in Canada found a stick of string cheese in his home and is taking a zero-waste approach to the discovery. Instead of just throwing it away, Angel Domingo put an ad on a billboard. The ad says the cheese is still in the original packaging. He says he's looking for a trade, but not any lowballs. Some of the offers he has gotten so far: Persian cats in a unique box of Lucky Charms cereal. Domingo hasn't said how much that billboard is costing him. It must be a lot.
Yeah, that's my question. How much money does he have, Jenna, to buy a billboard and talk about cheese?
I hope he enjoys his Persian cats and Lucky Charms.
I hope so, too. So check this one out. Starbucks facing a lawsuit claiming its refresher drinks don't actually contain the fruit they say they do. The beverages, which includes mango dragon fruit, lemonade, strawberry, a shiny lemonade maybe, and pineapple passion fruit lemonade, it doesn't contain some of the fruits advertised. The lawsuit claims people are paying, quote, a premium for false advertising. A Starbucks spokesperson says the allegations in the complaint are inaccurate and without merit. The spokesperson adds that the company looks forward to defending itself against these claims. There's always a lawsuit for everything, Jenna.
That's right, and I love those refreshers, so I will still be getting them anyway.
Well, what do you think? Is it enough fruit?
I think so. I mean, I'm not a coffee drinker, so to me, those refreshers are awesome.
Well, if Jenna says it's awesome, then it's awesome.
Yeah, no hate towards Starbucks ever.
Good people over there, absolutely. Well, coming up on Good Morning Augusta, new details on the FBI raid at former President